The museum was founded 30 years ago in 1977 by Marcia Tucker. We are fearless in what we show. We often will take on artists and subjects that other institutions won't touch. Consistent with our mission to present new art and new ideas, we wanted to work with an architect who had not built previously in New York and to give a young firm a chance to make a major statement. And SANAA's design had the clear advantage. It's a building that opens up. They showed one slide where they built out the full zoning envelope, and then they pulled the floors apart like a chest of drawers opening, and it was just in that one moment the clarity of their concept came forward.
They had designed several museums in Japan, so they truly understood how the architecture needed to function.
We proposed to make a museum very open to the city. We had an idea to get to the sifting. I mean, the gap can make a terrace, or a gallery can get the natural light through the gap. Through the light, people can feel also the city. So from the city, people can see something going on in the box.
We've always been a downtown institution, and after 9/11, we decided we were staying downtown. So we began looking and discovered that the Bowery was not very far away. This site itself is visible straight down Prince Street, so you have a very long view to this site, and that's unusual in New York.
Our first exhibition, Unmonumental, includes more than 30 artists. They explore the technique of assemblage, that is, more than two items juxtaposed to create a third thing. It is a challenge in a vertical building with three separate galleries to create a consistent whole. So the first floor has more traditional assemblage. The second floor really looks at the notion of a kind of the crumbling monument. On the top floor, we have a more hard edge work with a more obvious political message. We err on the side of youth and of freshness.
We asked all of the firms that were competing to use low-cost industrial materials. We also felt that it was very much in character with the neighborhood, with the Bowery. Originally, the building was designed as a very flat panel exterior, but then the architects felt that it needed something more sculptural and less monolithic. It's almost like drapery.
Its closest resemblance is to the New York City trash can. So it has this nod and wink to a real piece of street culture.
Depend on your position, always a building expresses a different impression to you, also under the different weather. So like today, the cloudy day, this appears very like softly, but in strong sunshine, this facade give some shining to the city.
And there's transparency to the mechanical systems in the building and the structure, so you can really see how the building is put together.
The galleries are rectangular with beautiful mixes of different kinds of light, from natural to incandescent to fluorescent sources. There are no columns, so that you get straight line spaces. One of the walls of each gallery follows the angled nature of the Bowery. Exterior of the building. It's also a way for the new museum to participate in public art. A well-known work of Ugo Rondinone really crystallizes our re-emergence into the cultural community. It's a gay positive sign, it's a rainbow sign, and it also is an important way for us to telegraph a wonderful history of gender activism that the museum is very famous for. The new museum was the home of ACT UP and its design and art arm, Grand Fury. This is an institution that was built by women and continues to be built by women. There's nothing wan or girly about the museum at all.
This museum always moves together with the city. It's a museum, but also some new type of public space. And I'm really happy to be able to join thinking in New York.